my husband must have come.
Yes, last time we spoke, you were intending to launch a program that you call Re-Engage.
Yeah, that's right.
Can you just tell us what's that all about and, and what's your vision with that intending to launch it in South Africa and how it will benefit the youth of our nation?
South Africa, that's true. Thank you, Pastor Rudy. The Re-Engage has been something that's been on my heart really since that time God spoke to me about the vision of getting into this fair. And I, the idea of Re-Engage is to be able to disciple young people to disciple the world.
Because
when we talk about discipleship, we're not just talking about salvation. You get people saved, but then you need to get them discipled. Then we've seen situations where we have Christians in leadership position all over the world, and they look like they're saved, but then they just mess up. They probably don't have the basic biblical principles of how to live their life. And that's what we do. Like if you look back at history of people that started the Reformation, people like Martin Luther, people like John Calvin, Abraham Kuyper, these men of God, they were not only looking into the salvation message, they actually took hold of their country. They changed the system. Because you know the story of Daniel, we talked about principalities. The meaning of principalities is a prince of a city. Every city has a prince in the spiritual world. You know, if you look back at the country where I come from, Nigeria, when you talk about Nigeria, people normally would just say it's a corrupt country because there's so much on tap, there's so much resources, but just in the hands of few people. That's a stronghold. So we want to disciple young people to say, okay, you dare to be different. And not just dare to be different, but also challenge the wrong views in your country. So for the nation like South Africa, we want to train young people that will look at the current views encroaching on the lives of people in South Africa and change that which is wrong and bring about that which is new, correct and true, because it's biblical.
That's right.
So we train young people into the different spheres of influence. Like you want to have a vision, or you have a vision to be in politics, for example. You are afraid that maybe you're going to lose your salvation. We're going to teach you from the Bible that God wants you to be a politician and wants you to be a good politician. And it has principles for people who want to be in government. You want to be a media practitioner, you want to work in the education system, you want to work as a scientist, you know, an engineer, you want to work as an entertainer. Because it's not, we just don't, God is not just, like, people think if you want to be a musician, then you all have to sing about God. Like, God give glory to God. You know? Whether we sing, like, for God to be glorified, we don't sing for Him to be glorified. God is already glorified. There's nothing more we can say about that. But God also is interested in Christians singing about peace. He's interested in Christians singing about love. Because if we don't do that, the enemy will raise people that will sing about love, and they will include sex in it. And the sad part is that the young people will listen to you because they don't have an alternative. We don't see from scriptures how we should entertain people and still entertain them in a godly way. And so these are some of the different spheres of influence that we do. So Re-Engage, the vision of Re-Engage is to change minds that will change the nation. And then we're launching that on the 5th of June. I'm using Bob Biggs and Y1.
Pastor Rudy has actually asked you a question, which I said is going to be towards the end, but it's good, because my question, you know, as a minister of missions, you were traveling extensively throughout the world, you know, can you just briefly also, you know, saying how God has brought you today, where you are today, and, you know, because I'm sure through traveling extensively, that is how God has laid on your heart to write the book concerning...
Correct.
Governance at creation.
Yeah.
And it is, as you said, changing minds and transforming nation.
Correct.
And also the Re-Engage of poverty. Can you just briefly explain, as a minister of missions, traveling extensively throughout?
Thank you, Pastor. It's been amazing. for me, since God brought me into ministry, there's been doors open everywhere.
Yeah.
I believe it's because God has a message for my mouth to share with the nations. It is true. The idea behind this book started in Belfast in 2005. We were there with a team to set up something called the Forgiveness Project.
Mm.
And the project was to help, I don't know if you know the story of Northern Ireland, the Catholics on another side and the Protestant on another side, and there's a wall dividing these two communities.
Yes,
and then this huge, huge war that has been going on for years.
Yeah.
So we prayed and we figured out that we can actually set up a curriculum called Forgiveness Curriculum with young people in primary schools, you know.
Yes.
So we started training them on what forgiveness is, so that they will carry that back home, and then it will carry that into the community.
Exactly.
But that's not. I was going to the Queen's University, one of the best universities in the world, if you want to go there, for a seminar. And on my way there, I saw these two girls. They were just being driven from a sex shop. I mean, you have sex shops all over in Europe.
Oh, it's
sad. Yeah.
Okay.
And then I was watching them as
in
I was
Europe,
coming.
Sorry.
Yeah. Mm. Well, that my own idea. I'm sure they're everywhere in the world.
Yes.
It's called. It's quite open in Europe. Mm. You know, this is a sex shop.
Oh.
So I saw them. They were being driven, and I'm sure the reason why they were being driven out was because they were underage. If they were like 18 and above, they would have been allowed in. But you could see the desperation on the faces of these girls. They were desperate to just want to test sex. So they were walking towards me, and they just walked past me. You know, in my mind, I was just been thinking like, oh, these girls are really young. You know,
yes.
I wonder. You know. What to do with them. And then one of them just asked me and said, excuse me, sir. So I turned and like, my friend would like to have sex with you. You don't worry, you don't have to pay anything. And I looked at them and I was just so sad. I became very sad.
Sorry, were they very young?
They were maybe like 13 or 14.
That's very young.
Very young, very young. So I looked at them and I was like, if it was back in Nigeria, I have the authority because we have a communal way of living in Africa. If they were like a sister of my friend or even anybody, I could just spank them immediately and say, no, don't do that again. Or just tell them like, you know, but you know, in Europe, you hardly know what to do. You hardly know what to talk to people so that they won't be offended, you know, all these things. So I looked at them and in a second, I just felt like, you guys should go on and talk to your parents. What you're doing is not good. And then I left and I was just walking to the university, but I was very sad in my heart.
Of course, yes.
I was very sad. And I felt in my heart like, but God didn't create anybody like this.
No.
This is a distorted view.
That is true.
I begin to now put my understanding of theology down on paper. Like, we are created to be governors.
That's right.
See, when God created us, He created us in His image.
Mm.
And we're created to be like God.
Amen.
You know, after God created Adam, this is very interesting. I'm just going to give this explanation. God created Adam in His image.
Mm.
Every word that Adam spoke came out of his personality as a God in this world.
Yes.
See, in our world today, the world we live in is shaped by the words that we speak.
Mm.
You know, you and I are in this room because of maybe Nelson Mandela, for example, or maybe you know, because of some of the words that he spoke about unity and peace in South Africa.
Right,
you,
right.
You know, and for us as Christians, the more words that comes out of our mouth, because we're created in the image of God, is going to translate into the world. Either it's going to be a peaceful world or a destructive world.
Yes, that's right.
Because after Eve came into being, God created Eve. Adam called her a woman.
That's right.
Until today, she's called woman.
That's right.
Isn't it?
Yes.
And every word that Adam spoke about animals, the same they've been called
today.
And I feel like, okay, so if we're created in the image of God, then we should start living like gods in the
yes,
world. So that's the reason why that title came, like we governors at creation. We create.
That is so right,
as
yes. Oh, that is so wonderful. I see my husband is signaling about the time here. I don't know how much we have left, but okay, Holy, thank you.
Thank
we
you.
Appreciate you coming with us today and speaking. This is not going to be the first time about, you know, especially the governance of at creation, because our Aries Africa Radiant TV network, where God gave us the one scripture, Genesis 1:1, yes, that in the beginning God created.
God.
And it is our creator. We must also be like our creator.
Amen.
On earth. So we so forth to whatever God has planted inside us. As you said, your heart got hurt and sore for to see that little children, and as you said, which is so true, it's not in God's plan to see little children going into sex trafficking. And we, our heart is for the youth today, for our generation, especially the youth. And you know, our you grew up as a youth. And last night we were interviewing youth from our communities, and that, you know, that were also in the naughty stage, that God has also raised up to be youth leaders today. And I can see, it's awesome and it's wonderful to see what our God can do, you know. And where God has taken you out, we're not going to talk about that. I believe we're going to talk more about that in the next program that we're going to do about governance at creation, because that is our topic that we're going to talk about. And I just want you to speak, you know, your final encouraging words for the next time, and also your what you hope to achieve, especially with the re-engagement concerning the communities as such, and also the nations.
Thank you, Pastor. For the youth, I can speak for, I'm still very young, very, very young. I'm just 30 years old.
Yes, you
are. But I can tell you, like, sometimes I feel like I can take the whole world.
Yes.
And I run that with a passion. And I want to challenge you, if you're watching us, that don't look at yourself as small. One, you're created in the image of God. That means you are in the class of God.
Yes.
He didn't create you to watch pornography. Mm-hmm. He didn't create you to be violent. He created you in his own image.
Yes.
And you see, when you start to have that in your subconscious every time, you think as a ruler.
Mm-hmm.
You think like, I'm in charge of my sphere.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
See, if I'm in a family and I have parents, I have sisters, I have brothers, I am created to be responsible for them.
Mm-hmm.
Because then you grow with this attitude,
mm-hmm.
and you become a most respected person in your own sphere. And I want you to carry this in your subconscious. You know, as you grow older, you know, behave like the son of the king, and you will find fulfillment in everything you do. I mean, you carry the aroma of the king.
That's
you
right.
Know, wherever
the
you go,
yes.
You know, wherever you go, you smell kingly, and
yes.
people will bow down to you for that. Every word in the scripture, my friend, they are true.
Amen. That is so
they are true.
Right.
You just need to start flowing into it for you to recognize it. But if you keep it aside and you feel like, well, this is not working, this is just a fiction, this is not true.
Yeah.
You will never understand what God is saying in
that
his word.
So
but once you pick his word and start living it, I'm sure we're going to have another time of meeting. But then I have numerous testimonies. Since 2001 that I started traveling, there is no single year that I've not been to two countries to preach the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
And I have like numerous villages that I've been to, you know, talking about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And his passion.
Amen.
And I tell you, there's so much that you will achieve. Re-engage is going to help a lot of young people. We've trained over 1,000 people in 5 countries, in the Netherlands, in Germany, in England, in Nigeria, in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're in South Africa. We're sure like we're going to train thousands of
That's
people
right.
to become effective in the calling that God has given them.
So much.
God has called you to be politicians. You will be politician. You will change the course of this nation. God has called you to media. You will be a media practitioner. You will change the course of media in the whole world. You will change the face of media in the whole world because you're created for that purpose and for now. And whatever sphere God has called you into, you join us at Reengage. We will dig deeper into the scriptures. You will get the juice of what God is saying about you, because God had a plan from the creation, before the creation of the world. That's what the scripture said.
Yeah.
He had you in his mind.
Amen.
And there's so many things in his word that he has ready for you to function in the area of your calling. I am excited. I could talk for hours about this.